Let's start the second part of our first lesson. See here. To understand the changes in the location of sunrise and sunset on the horizon, let us carry out the activity given on the next page. As we know, when we observe the position of sun day by day at horizon, at the sunrise timing and at the sunset, we seen that day by day the position of sun is goes changes. Why this happen or what actually happen, let's see by this activity on next page. See here, the activity is given here. You can see a picture. Paste a large white paper on one side of the table. See here, there is one of table and a white paper is pasted on it. Place a torch in front of the table in such a way that it wouldn't move. See here, this is the torch and it arranged so that it wouldn't move. Stand a rod or candle between the white paper and the torch. See here, here's the rod is stand in between torch and white paper. Direct the light beam of the torch in such a way that the shadow of the rod candle falls on the paper. This is the light beam which falls on this rod and you can see shadow which appears on white paper. Mark the position of the shadow on the paper. See here, here's a sign is seen which is the position of shadow. Move the table along with the rod candle from one side to other slowly. As we move this table, observe and mark the position of the shadow of that falls on the paper. You can see when we move this table, the shadow also moving on white paper and we have to mark it. Note the change in the location of the shadows. Then we have to note that shadow's position. Let's discuss geographical explanation about this activity. From this activity you will realize that as the position of the table changes, the position of the shadow also changes. As we move the table's position, the shadow's position also change. If the position of the sunrise and sunset on the horizon are observed for the whole year, you will realize that they keep on changing. Let us try to understand the reason behind this with the help of the next activity. Yes, we know that when we observe the sun throughout the year, the position of sun goes changes. Let's try the next activity and now find out the reason behind this. So the next activity is, see here. Take a thick stick about 1.5 to 1.7 meter long. Keeping some distance, fix the stick near a wall that receives sunlight at the time of sunrise or sunset throughout the year. That means, see in the figure, we have to fix a stick in front of a wall which receives sunlight at sunrise time and also as sunset time throughout the year. Remember that the stick has to be fixed at this spot for a period of about 1 year. Whole 1 year we have to fix this stick. After the observation, mark the position of the shadow for that day. At the sunrise time and at the sunset time, we have to mark their positions. If the position of the shadow changes, measure and note the distance between earlier and the change position. We know that the position of this stick's shadow goes changes, we have to note that position and note the distance between earlier and change position. During the period of this activity, also observe the place of sunrise and sunset on the horizon as well. While doing this activity, we have to observe the position of sun at the horizon, that means in the sky. The next part of this lesson should be deal in next month of September. That means this is the half part of how seasons occur, part 1, and the half of part is discussed at lesson number 8. We can see here there is a note. See here, The second half of this lesson is deal at chapter number 8. So, from this activity, we can find the answer of this 3 questions. See here, study the duration of daytime and nighttime on the basis of their observation from the table for the month of September. What was the direction of the shadow of the stick in the month of September? And on which day was the duration of the day and the night?